FAA finally announced a big update on Starship's Flight 4 and upcoming, Flight 5. Rocket Lab wins government support. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we have an exciting update from the FAA regarding the Flight 4 launch. Also, let's take a look at what's ahead for SpaceX from the regulatory side for Starship's Flight 5. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, has adopted a unique regulatory approach to SpaceX's Starship program, which has been making significant strides in space technology with a focus on reusability and rapid development. In the United States, regulatory compliance is crucial, and the FAA plays a vital role in ensuring public safety. Recently, the FAA announced that it would not require an investigation into the fourth Starship launch, marking a significant shift in their regulatory approach. This decision was made after assessing the operations and determining that all flight events for both the Starship vehicle and the Super Heavy booster occurred within the scope of planned and authorized activities. We all know that the Starship program has faced regulatory hurdles since its inception, with the initial orbital test flight on April 20th, 2023, delayed due to environmental reviews and regulatory approvals. Despite SpaceX's preparations, the FAA required extensive assessments and safety checks before granting the launch license. Unfortunately, the launch ended in failure, with the Starship exploding over the Gulf of Mexico just 3 minutes into the flight. The FAA's investigation into the mishap identified multiple root causes and outlined 63 corrective actions for SpaceX to implement. These included hardware redesigns, launchpad strengthening, and more rigorous design reviews. However, SpaceX has been critical of the FAA's regulatory framework, with Elon Musk stating that it is outdated and ill-suited for the rapid pace of space innovation. Despite these challenges, SpaceX has made significant progress in streamlining the regulatory process. The time between launches has decreased steadily, from 212 days between the first and second launches to just 84 days between the third and fourth launches. This acceleration is attributed to a more streamlined process with the FAA and reduced preparation time for SpaceX. Before the fourth launch, SpaceX and the FAA reached a unique agreement. SpaceX proposed three specific scenarios that would not require a mishap investigation: thermal protection system failure during re-entry, flap failure during re-entry, and Raptor engine failure during the landing burn. The FAA analyzed these scenarios, assessed the risks, and confirmed that they met public safety requirements, subsequently approving them. This agreement allowed SpaceX to focus on the overall mission success without the potential delay of investigations. During the fourth flight, SpaceX encountered some major problems, including engine failure, heat shield loss, and flap damage. However, the pre-approved scenarios enabled the FAA to overlook the engine issue, and the flap issue will be reviewed rather than investigated. The FAA's working process after Flight 4 is expected to be greatly shortened. This flexibility, combined with the new pre-approved scenarios, means that Flight 5 is likely to take place within the next 3 months. SpaceX will likely incorporate several improvements and upgrades based on the data from Flight 4, including addressing Raptor engine issues, thermal protection system improvements, and flap repairs. Additionally, SpaceX will attempt to catch the booster with the tower arms, a significant milestone if successful. This would involve a precise landing burn and careful navigation to align the booster with the catching arms, a process that has been thoroughly tested and simulated. The Starship program's progress is a testament to the balance between innovation and public safety, and we can expect many more exciting developments in the future. As SpaceX continues to push the boundaries of space technology, the FAA's regulatory approach will play a crucial role in ensuring that safety and innovation go hand in hand. With the Starship program, SpaceX is not only developing a reusable spacecraft, but also paving the way for a human settlement on Mars. The FAA's flexible approach to regulation will be essential in achieving this goal, and we can expect many more milestones in the future. The success of the Starship program will have far-reaching implications for the space industry, and the FAA's regulatory approach will set a precedent for future space missions. As we move forward in this new era of space exploration, it is essential to strike a balance between innovation and public safety. And the FAA's approach to the Starship program is a significant step in the right direction. A quick reminder, some of our members have mentioned that they're not receiving notifications for our new uploads. To help resolve this, please take a moment to like this video, ensure the notification bell is turned on, and finally double-check that you're subscribed to our community. Your time and attention to this matter are greatly appreciated, and I want you all to stay connected with us. Rocket Lab, a leading space technology company, has announced a significant milestone in its expansion plans for its New Mexico factory. The company has secured nearly $50 million in federal and state funding to enhance its production of space-grade solar cells. This development is a crucial step forward for Rocket Lab's efforts to diversify its offerings beyond launch vehicles and into space systems. At the heart of this achievement is a non-binding preliminary memorandum of terms, PMT, signed with the U.S. Department of Commerce on June 11th. This agreement unlocks access to up to $23.9 million in funding from the CHIPS and Science Act, a 2022 bill that allocated over $50 billion to stimulate the development of semiconductor production in the United States. The PMT is a precursor to a final funding award, pending further due diligence and negotiations with the Commerce Department. In addition to the federal funding, Rocket Lab has secured $25.5 million in financial assistance and incentives from the state of New Mexico. The company itself is investing more than $70 million in the project, according to the New Mexico Economic Development Department. This substantial investment will drive the expansion of Rocket Lab's Albuquerque facility, formerly owned by Solar Aero Technologies, which the company acquired in 2022. The expansion project aims to increase solar cell production by 50% over the next 3 years, creating over 100 new manufacturing jobs in the process. The facility has a rich history of producing solar cells for various commercial and government spacecraft, including the OneWeb constellation and the James Webb Space Telescope. Peter Beck, Rocket Lab's CEO, highlighted the significance of this development, stating, "For more than two decades, the Solero team, now part of Rocket Lab, has played a crucial role in the domestic production of semiconductors. This program is a continuation of our commitment to ensuring resilient U.S. supply chains and creating highly productive local jobs." This award marks the first instance of funding under the CHIPS program, dedicated primarily to space-related semiconductor production. While BA Systems received a $35 million CHIPS grant in December 2023 for producing semiconductors for defense and aerospace applications, Rocket Lab's award is the first focused specifically on space-grade solar cells. In the broader context of the CHIPS program, Rocket Lab's award is a relatively small fraction of the overall funding allocated to date. According to the Semiconductor Industry Association, the federal government has made $29.5 billion in grant awards to nine companies before the Rocket Lab announcement, with multi-billion dollar awards going to companies like Intel, Micron, and Samsung. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo emphasized the importance of this funding, stating, "Solar cells are important for keeping our communication and space technology powered and operational, and this proposed award would help our military, NASA, and our commercial space industry have access to the specialty semiconductors they need to keep our country safe and continue to lead in scientific discoveries and space commerce." As part of the funding agreements, Rocket Lab has committed to collaborating with New Space Nexus, formerly New Space New Mexico, a nonprofit organization focused on growing New Mexico's space industry. The company will contribute $2 million over 3 years to support the organization's business and workforce development programs. In conclusion, Rocket Lab's securing of nearly $50 million in federal and state funding marks a significant milestone in the company's expansion plans for its New Mexico solar cell factory. This development not only enhances Rocket Lab's capabilities in space-grade solar cell production, but also contributes to the growth of the U.S. space industry and the creation of new jobs in New Mexico. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.